take us through the play that led to the ejection.
The play was D'Lo driving to the basket, nice little drop off to Jay, which he was doing throughout the whole game, went up for a shot, for a layup. I thought it was a hard foul on Embiid. I thought he hit a little bit of the arm, the ball. I thought the follow through kind of hit him on the head and or hit him on his like neck area and fell down. And it's just something that's just been escalating for a while. Game, I think it was game two, the elbow falling down when it should have been a flagrant two. They didn't call a flagrant two. Then they're in the press conference laughing, and then I see it like that. And so how I thought it was just a good push, letting them know it was, we're not having it today. I got pushed, which is fine. And then we get up, we go, our both separate. Should have been a double tech, double, if you want to do flagrant on both, and both teams said for them to eject not only Jimmy, but myself, it's ridiculous. This is no punches were thrown. No one acted, no one said anything crazy out there. It was a good playoff. Foul on his part, push on my part, and then go separate ways.
You provided a lift while out there. What were you trying to give the team in terms of intensity during the time that you were out there?
Well, you gotta understand, this is the team that, you know, they're the 3 seed for a reason. And for us is, you know, we have to play harder. We have to be more aggressive. We're undermanned. Obviously, Ed didn't play today. That happens in playoff basketball. I didn't play game two. Joel didn't play. And so it was the intensity that Brooklyn has to play to be competitive in this series. And so for us, if it gets a little scrappy, if you get under people's skin, that's just a part of basketball. But I thought it was just good playoff basketball tonight.
Were you trying to send the message at all?
And if so, yeah, for sure, send a message. Send a message is like, you know, when you have a guy getting flagrant fouls. I mean, Joel Embiid's second in the league in flagrant fouls. And so for that elbow he had before, just to have a flagrant one, no fine, no nothing, laughing in the media. And if you think that a team that I play on is going to have that, that's another thing coming, especially on this young team. This team hasn't been here before. They don't know. And, you know, they can change the rules all they want and make it, you know, throw guys out. That's fine. I will take that push every time.
Looking at the way the score resulted by the end of the game, do you feel like that changed it swung the momentum a little bit?
Possibly. I mean, but just I was playing well. I thought that me taking Ben Simmons out of the game, making other people have to play, I thought that they hit key shots. I mean, this was going to go down on the wire either way. I would like to have been in the game. I think that Jimmy would have liked to have been in the game, but I think both teams would like to have their guys in. I think neither player deserved to be ejected. I think when you watch the film, I guarantee you, and I probably talked to Kiki, he probably will agree, and so it's just unfortunate.
You think Embiid should have been ejected?
I wouldn't say ejected, a flagrant. It could have been a flagrant. And so, hey, it's playoff basketball. I have no problem with a flagrant one. I had a problem with the elbow to the face and laughing in the press conference. And so if they don't want to give him a flagrant, I'll take a flagrant. But an ejection, there's no punches thrown. No one fell on the ground. If anything, I got pushed to the ground. And so if you would have said Jimmy for the push to the ground, and even I don't think he should have been ejected for that.
What are the adjustments that have to be made to bring this series back to Brooklyn?
An adjustment, obviously, you got to slow down. I mean, Joel Embiid had a good game tonight. I think that good thing for us, game one, the one thing that you saw that took away is we got JJ in foul trouble, was attacking that. I thought we did a good job of that. I think that you got to credit them, just keep going at it. That's a good team. And so for us, it's playing with intensity, getting our rebounds. I thought rebound first half was good. They're going to hit shots. They got three or four, five talented players. And so it's the intensity where a regular season compared to the playoffs. And our team is learning that on the fly. And so for me, it was setting the tone, obviously starting, guarding Ben, trying to limit him, trying to help out off him to help on my other teammates, and then offensively provide a spark.
Knowing the end result of the ejection, would you have done anything different if you knew that that's what
I would not have. I would not have, just because, for one, it's me being better on this team of showing these young guys a certain way you have to. If anything, I probably would have got my money's worth a little bit more on that push. That push wasn't even that bad. I mean, he didn't fall down. If anything, I fell down. But it's a certain thing, and for the league to have to look at that. Like I said, Joel Embiid second in the league in flagrant fouls. He just got a flagrant one, almost hitting the guy. I mean, if it would have been anyone else, if he would have sold it a little bit more falling down, that was a crucial elbow. Laughing about it, no fine. If anything, I should have gotten worse.
It looked like you and Simmons both kind of went into the first row there. Can you describe what happened?
I got pushed from, I don't even know who, I think it was Jimmy, and then when I pushed it, Simmons was there, so we both kind of went down together.
Did you see it as having your teammates back? That was the reason.
Sure. Man, I mean, if it had been a regular season, I would have done it, especially with the history. Now, if it would have been, if the elbow didn't transpire game two with the laughing press conference, would I have probably done that? Probably not. And so I think the history had to play in with that. And this is, I mean, at the end of the day, I have no problem with what Joel did and Jimmy does. But it's, on this team, for me, you stand up when it's time to stand up. And that was that case. And I think that was just good playoff basketball, two techs, and keep the game going.